Maharashtra government has also now come out and announced that it is going to follow the lockdown guidelines as issued by the center. So standalone shops across the state, excluding in Mumbai and Pune, will remain open. Private offices can also open in all places except Mumbai and Pune. Private offices, as the center says, can be allowed to work with 33% workforce. And manufacturing units of essential goods will also be permitted. Let me, in fact, go across to Mayuresh to understand all of this better. Mayuresh, if you can take us through what the Maharashtra government is saying, because very clearly there are a different set of rules for the biggest hotspots of Mumbai and Pune and a different set of rules for the rest of the state.
Certainly, if you remember in a press con, in a meeting with all the CMs, the PM had said that the state has to decide about the containment zone and the red zone and what kind of relaxation they want to lift or they want to give. So right now, the order which Maharashtra government has issued, it clearly says that the private offices can start with the minimum staff. They have mentioned the percentage in that order, but they have excluded Mumbai, MMR region, Pune and Pimpri Chinchwad, because these are the hotspots in the state. So they have excluded these hotspots, and they have said that in these areas, no private offices can work or remain open, or even not even the school, colleges, or the government offices can work, but the employees have to be limited. So they have mentioned the limit in the order. So this is one difference which we have found. If you go by the MHA order doesn't mention this kind of thing, but yes, Maharashtra government has mentioned that private offices can remain open, excluding Mumbai, Pune, MMR region and Pimpri Chinchwad area.
Right. And Mayuresh, we've also been seeing a lot of the other states who have now decided to start reopening liquor shops. Is there any word from the Maharashtra government on whether or not they're thinking on those lines right now, of course, outside the hotspots?
See, even in last lockdown order, there was no mention of a liquor order. Similarly, there is no mention of a liquor in this entire order. Or the wine shop will remain open. The line which clearly says that the bars and the restaurants will remain closed. But there is no mention of a liquor shop, whether liquor shop will remain open or whether liquor shop will shut. If you remember, in the last lockdown order, the health minister of Maharashtra had clearly said that if people follow the social distancing norm, then they can think of opening the liquor shops. Today also, we asked the same question to Guardian Minister of Maharashtra, but he clearly denied and he clearly said that after the lockdown, we will think on it.
Right. And Mayuresh, specifically for Mumbai and Pune, given the kind of the number of cases that we've been seeing and the high rate of spread that's happening in both these cities at this point in time, what is it going to be like for the containment zones, specifically for the areas which are sealed? Any word on that?
See, if you go by the order which Maharashtra government has issued, containment zones, especially the hotspots, everything remain as it is. Even the standalone shops, even the saloons will not open. Even the shops of the grocery will have some kind of limitation. So whatever the previous order mentioned or the whatever the MHA order has mentioned is as per the same. Nothing has changed for the red zone or the hotspots like Mumbai, Pune, Pimpri Chinchwad.
All right, Mayuresh, thank you so much for joining us with all of those details. So essentially, as far as Maharashtra is concerned, for most of the state, it's going to be more or less in line with what the MHA order says. But for Mumbai and Pune, things are pretty much going to be the same. Remember, Mumbai, Pune, hard-hit cities with coronavirus cases. So things will remain the same. There are going to be no relaxations specifically in both these cities. So that's as far as Maharashtra is concerned. But let's now move on to the national capital. Delhi has said that essentially it is going to be following the MHA guidelines and the MHA order and will be allowing for relaxations in the red zones as permitted by the center.
Containment zone ke hisab se nahi kiya gaya hai. Kendra Sarkar ne jo kiya hai wo district ke hisab se kiya hai. तो डिस्ट्रिक्ट के हिसाब करने से पूरी दिल्ली रेड जोन
सर, यानी कि हम मान के चले कि दिल्ली के लिहाज से अभी कुछ छूट नहीं मिलने वाली है और जो रेड जोन की स्थिति है जो बताई है डिस्क्राइब की गई है केंद्र द्वारा वही रहेगी दिल्ली।
रेड जोन के अंदर जो जो छूट दी गई है वो सारी लागू होंगी, रेड जोन के जो भी नियम है वो सारे लागू होंगे। मतलब आप 17 तक की बात करेंगे तो दिल्ली 17 तारीख तक रेड जोन में ही है।
Let's in fact go across to Alok, who's joining us for more details. Alok, take us through what really is going to be the process that Delhi is going to be following, and of course the other development, Delhi also looking at reopening liquor shops.
Yes, absolutely. In fact, Delhi is in the process of opening the liquor shop. They are mulling into it how they can open, because there are strict guidelines from the central government that whichever shop is opened, there will be complete assurance of social distancing. So they are looking into it. There is the possibility that by Monday, the liquor shops will be opened in Delhi. But as far as other guidelines of the central government is concerned, because Delhi comes under the red zone, so definitely Delhi is very much critical. Remember, a number of cases are increasing daily. But as far as the red zones guidelines are concerned, if you talk about a very less number of relaxation is given to the red zone, which include that construction work could be started, and also private offices can also be opened, but with 33% of his staff. The Delhi government is just announcing this. However, Delhi Minister Satyajit has just announced that they are going to impose whatever the relaxation given by the central government under for the districts which comes under the red zone. Remember, Delhi's all 11 districts comes under the red zone. So we hope that people who are in the national capital, they will follow the orders. But it is unfortunate that the people still have to wait for the relaxation of in the national capital.
All right, Alok, thank you so much for joining us with all of those details. So that's as far as the national capital is concerned. Let's now move to Tamil Nadu, which has also decided to ensure that they are in line with what the MHA has decided and the guidelines that the MHA has issued. So they will be following that more or less the same way as far as the categorization of zones are concerned and the relaxations that will be allowed in those zones as well. And also they will allow the functioning of industries as permitted by the central government. Now, Pramod joining me for more details. Pramod, what can you tell us about the Tamil Nadu government and what exactly are they going to be doing for the next 2 weeks?
Well, in the state of Tamil Nadu, there is a different kind of pattern that is emerging right now, where various other districts have turned orange, but except for a district that is surrounding Chennai, the capital. In fact, the numbers are steadily increasing, and that is turning into a huge worrisome for the state. And that's the reason, along with the center's guidelines about separating the districts into red, orange and green, the Tamil Nadu government has gone ahead and tweaked the plan a bit, by which actually they have given two separate relaxations, one for Chennai and the other for entire state of Tamil Nadu, converting it into urban rural areas alone. In the city of Chennai and for the entire state of Tamil Nadu, there will be no relaxations in containment zones. Chennai alone has 198 containment zones, and there will be no relaxations over there. Across the state of Tamil Nadu, saloons and hair spas will not work. Other than that, when it comes to industries in rural areas and urban areas, what they have done is that they are allowing a workforce with a minimum of 20% or a maximum of 50%. This after the district collectors go ahead over there and do a supervision as to how they are going to provide all this social distancing and various other norms. But when it comes to standalone shops, permission has been provided with a time span from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. And for essential item serving shops and hotels, 6 a.m. to for essential service providing shops, 6 a.m. to 5 p.m. is a time period which has been extended from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. And for hotels, they can operate from 6 a.m. to 9 p.m., but only parcel services, serving food inside the hotel. So these kind of regulations have been brought in. These are relaxations across Tamil Nadu, except for locations in containment zones. So this way, they have a little bit tweaked the plan for the state of Tamil Nadu.
All right, Pramod, thanks for joining us with all of those details. So from Tamil Nadu, that's the way it's going to be as far as the MHA guidelines are concerned and how it's going to be implemented. Meanwhile, Karnataka government as well has said that they will be following the MHA order and allowing for the relaxations of certain activities in red zones as well. That, of course, is as far as Karnataka is also concerned. It was going to be following the relaxations allowed by the Home Ministry. Liquor stores also, meanwhile, in Karnataka will be open from the 4th of May. Standalone liquor shops can remain open. So several of the states now have started looking at reopening liquor shops. Remember, the tax collected on liquor sales is a big source of revenue for states. And that is why many of them are now opening up liquor shops as well. Neha joining us for more details. Neha, take us through what's it going to be like in Karnataka. One big change, of course, is going to be that liquor shops will be open.
Well, absolutely, Avni, that's right. In fact, the biggest announcement that's actually coming right now from the Karnataka government is the fact that standalone liquor shops would be allowed to remain open, even in the red zones, barring all the containment zones. Remember that Karnataka has, many containment zones, and in the Bengaluru city, in the capital alone, there are about 25 containment zones. So barring this, of course, if we also look at industries and shops as well, all industries would be allowed to open again, barring containment zones. Shops also, of course, all of them except the multi-brand and single-brand outlets would again allowed to be, remain open. But a concern over here, of course, being the fact that with the liquor stores opening, there could be a lot of crowds that actually gather around these stores. So in order to ensure that does not happen, there are very stringent rules that have been put in place. Only 5 people will be allowed at one point in time. There has to be a minimum of 6 feet distance between 2 persons. Everyone is, of course, mandated to wear masks already in Bengaluru. And apart from that, also, these liquor shop owners will be entirely responsible to make sure that, there's no sort of crowd that actually gathers around. So hopefully, of course, this should ideally help boost the economy that's already, taken a hit, especially the Exchequer in Karnataka, 2,000 crores from the excise department alone. So we'll really have to wait and see how this pans out and whether people actually adhere to the lockdown now going forward.
All right, Neha, thanks so much for joining us with all of those details. So that's as far as Karnataka is concerned.